Hello everyone, you're watching PokerNews.com and welcome to the end of our coverage here at the 888 live in London. I am with your champion, Huntley. Now this was a really interesting sort of spot in terms of how the final table played out. We had a lot of quick bust outs and then things would really slow down, and then a couple quick bust outs and then things really slowed down. And I think, you know, heads up, your opponent was a pretty tight player. Yeah. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about, you know, your experience with the heads up and how you had to adjust your play at all these sort of parts in the tournament where things were changing really quickly.
Actually, I play quite a lot of heads up online on PokerStars, and so I am quite familiar with it. I'm used to it. I'm not scared of playing him heads up, so I was quite comfortable playing him heads up.
You're like, heads up is my game, good boy. Well, I wanted to talk to you because, you know, in terms of the payout structure here, you know, the difference between third, second, and first was really vast. It made a big difference. So did that affect the way that you were playing at all?
Not really, because I was already really happy that I made the final nine. So I was just playing for the win, basically.
For the win, that's what it's all about, baby. Well, now that you have it, and what is maybe around £50,000, but we don't know, maybe a deal, we'll just say it's £50,000. It's a great victory. It was a really tough field. Just tell me a little bit about, you know, what it feels like to capture a title in such a strong field like this.
Well, I feel really fortunate. This is my first live victory, and so I was really happy about it. To be honest, I didn't expect to win this because I came to day two with like average stack. So, I mean, it's a playable stack, but I really didn't expect me to make the final day or even the final table. So, yeah, it was good.
Well, and then I wanted to ask too, because you were one of the shorter stacks coming into the final nine, and this is something I talk about all the time. You know, I think people have all these assumptions about what it means to have a big stack coming to the final table, but a lot of the times I think it's the shorter stacks that take it. So just talk a little bit about, you know, keeping your head in the game and making sure that you don't get discouraged by, you know, where your chip stacks are right in the moment.
Well, basically I just like stay focused and basically just wait for the hands to come, and to be honest, I went quite lucky, so I hit a few set, so yeah, you have to get lucky to win, so.
You gotta have both, baby. It is London, of course, and it's early enough that I feel like you can get some celebrating done, so I will let you enjoy your night.
Thank you.
A huge congratulations. I'm Sarah Herring, you guys are with us, and thank you so much for tuning into our coverage here on PokerNews.com.